Honk, honk, quiet wobbles the goose.
You are a fluke of the universe. You have no right to be
placidly amid the noise and waste, and remember what comfort there may be in owning a piece thereof. Avoid quiet and passive persons unless you are in need of sleep. Rotate your tires. Speak glowingly of those greater than yourself, and heed well their advice, even though they be turkeys. Know what to kiss and when. Consider that two wrongs never make a right, but that three do. Wherever possible, put people on hold. Be comforted that in the face of all aridity and disillusionment, and despite the changing fortunes of time, there is always a big future in computer maintenance.
You are a
remember the Pueblo. Strive at all times to bend, fold, spindle, and mutilate. Know yourself. If you need help, call the FBI. Exercise caution in your daily affairs, especially with those persons closest to you. That lemon on your left, for instance. Be assured that a walk through the ocean of most souls would scarcely get your feet wet. Fall not in love, therefore. It will stick to your face. Gracefully surrender the things of youth, birds, clean air, tuna, Taiwan, and let not the sands of time get in your lunch. Hire people with hooks. For a good time, call 606-4311. Ask for Ken. Take heart amid the deepening gloom that your dog is finally getting enough cheese. And reflect that whatever misfortune may be your lot, it could only be worse in Milwaukee.
You are a fluke of the universe.
You have no right to be here. And whether you can hear it or not, the universe is laughing behind your back. Therefore, make peace with your God, whatever you conceive him to be, hairy thunderer or cosmic muffin, with all its hopes, dreams, promises, and urban renewal, the world continues to deteriorate. Give up.
You are a
the world's weekly wait is over. Like magic, an invisible chain of sound once more circles the planet. The National Lampoon Radio Hour is ready again to girdle the globe with giggles.
This is London standing by. Come in, please. National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Nicht dit verstolzen, ihr Heiden, das Berlinen. Wir warten auf Gespräbietenen, das Zäunke Kachauben, bei Schleunfein Kräben der National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Moskau. Did it those movies in National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Campagne du Paris.
Na, Ferdrot, ich will die
National Lampoon Radio.
Come in, please. National Lampoon Radio.
This is Calcutta standing by. Please, now to come in, National Lampoon Radio Hour.
This is Los Angeles, California standing by. Come in, please, National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Our worldwide network is ready, and here in New York City, the cast and crew of the National Lampoon Radio Hour are in their places. The orchestra leader has raised his baton, so, Mr. Engineer, will you pull the master switch?
Oh, no, not again. Due to technical difficulties, the National Lampoon Radio Hour returns you to your local station where a commercial is already in progress.
Hey, guys, you're tired of talking like this with no class? A real cruddy accent that turns the broads off, makes everybody laugh at you behind your back, huh? You're being held back from high-paying career opportunities by the way you talk? L'Académie de Indianapolis de l'accent français to the rescue. That is, my friend, the Indianapolis Academy of the French accent. Yes, that is right. In 10 days only, your whole life it can change, my friend. You can become the most popular man in your shop, your factory, your office, and the girls, they are, how you say, pudding in the hand, oui? The Indianapolis Academy of the French accent, it is not a school of the language, no, no, no. No boring grammar, no silly exercise to study. We teach you not a single word of the French, only the accent, in the privacy of your own home. No high school diploma necessary, no, no. No previous training in the language. My friend, it is so easy, and in 10 days only, you will speak English with a charming, authentic French accent. You do not believe me, eh? That is understandable, mon ami. But listen to the satisfied students, oui?
I was going, how you say, nowhere in a big hurry because, well, mon ami, because I sound like, how you say, a pig with my bad accent in English. But now, after only 10 days study with the Indianapolis Academy of French accent, voilà! I am now head of the old shipping department.
Alors, it was incredible. The Indianapolis Academy of the French accent changed my life. Imagine me, a simple kid from the Bronx, head waitress in a fancy restaurant.
Yes, my friend, it really worked. Why not enroll now? Here is all the information you need.
All right. Send $10 with your name and address to Indianapolis Academy of the French Accent, Box 411, Indianapolis, Indiana. All right, that's Indianapolis Academy of the French Accent, Box 411, Indianapolis, Indiana. You got it.
And now, radio listeners, The Lost Glider. Come join us in the mystery ship of the air lanes, lost in the trackless wastes of an endless sky. Let's listen.
I don't know where I am.
Listen in again next time as the law.
Keep on keeping on your toughness. I got to eat your curse. I got to. to eat your way. Have mercy, eat your way into my heart.
And now, the White Ladies.
Gosh, Nancy, I just don't know what to do.
What's the matter, Sue?
Last week, a man moved into the house next door, and he's African American. But when he introduced himself, I wasn't overcome with feelings of rage and animal fear.
Gee, Sue, sounds like you've met a non-threatening black man.
A non-threatening black man? What's that?
It's a male Negro who fails to trigger the customary fight-or-flight response in Caucasian women due to his non-specific physical and sociocultural attributes, like Al Roker or Bryant Gumbel.
But if he's a non-threatening black man, why isn't he a newscaster?
Not all non-threatening black men are newscasters. Some of them work in advertising.
Oh, this is all so confusing. What should I do?
Move. He may be non-threatening to you, but your property values sure won't know the difference.
Gosh, you're right. I'll go home and start packing right away. But what will I tell the kids?
Tell them to fear people who are different.
Thanks, Nancy. What would I do without you?
This is National Lampoon Radio.
We're going to do something now that I know you like, that we do every day. We're going to take a walk in our neighborhood. So, let's go up the steps. 1, 2, 3. Let's open the door. Let's go outside in the yard, okay? Can you say that? Yard? Sure you can. Hey, we're outside now. Isn't it nice? There's a little doggy asleep in the shade over there. His name is Kalijah.
Hey, Roberts.
He's cute, isn't he? Can you say that? Cute?
Roberts, can I talk to you for just a minute?
It's our friend Mr. Heyman from across the way. He has the house right next to ours. He's going to be coming over here in a minute to talk to us.
Yeah, I just
want to
have a word with you, Roberts.
Hi, Mr. Heyman. How are you?
How you doing? I'm doing pretty
good. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, isn't it?
Yeah, it's pretty good, except I got something on my mind.
Well, anything you'd like to say, you can say to me.
Well, my son Timmy, he's been spending a lot of time at your house.
Timmy's special kid.
Yeah, well, frankly, I don't like him spending so much time over at your house.
Timmy has to feed my fish. That's his special job.
Well, he's not going to feed him anymore, because I told him not to go over to your house anymore, and I'd appreciate it if you'd stay away from him. You understand what I'm talking about?
I thought you might have liked the lederhosen that I made for him.
No, I didn't like it. I thought it was an unusual gift for an adult man to give a child.
I lined him with silk so they wouldn't chafe him in the summer.
Yeah, listen, and I
was going to put a zipper in, but I thought the buttons would be good
for his
fingers.
What I'm talking about is you and the children in the neighborhood. I think you spend an inordinate amount of time with kids, you know? You don't seem to have any adult friends. You don't seem to have a job of any kind. You don't go to work. You just hang around feeding the fish and walking around the neighborhood. Do you do anything for a living, Fred?
I like to get up in the morning and like to put my feet in a wading pool and turn on the hose and wash them, you know? Sure.
That's
a special feeling, you know?
You make money off of this, Fred?
What are you driving at?
Well, the thing I'm wondering about is Al Morton, you know, Al on the street. And
he's a policeman, isn't he?
He sure is. And his son, Skip.
Sure, he's a sergeant. He has 3 stripes.
Skipper says you touched him last Tuesday, all right?
Touched him?
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about?
Can you say deja vu?
Can you say molest? Can you say that?
Molest? Sure.
You know what that means?
Sure.
Yeah, you know what we're talking about then, huh?
Sure, I do.
All right. Okay, I got a petition here. 18 names. Parents in the neighborhood like you out of the neighborhood. You know what I'm talking about?
Sure.
I want you out. Do you understand? Because we don't like you.
Well, I
don't like your face. I don't like the way you comb your hair. I don't like those shoes. You know what I mean?
Well, I like it here.
I don't like that sweater. You know, I noticed you buttoned your sweater.
Sure, I did.
Well, Fred, you forgot to tie your shoes.
My shoes? What do you mean? Oh, gee, that hurts, you know. Oops, there goes my loafer. Bloody nose.
Closet queen,
come out and play. Change that gabardine to gold lame. Why deny the guy you are? Throw away that fat cigar. Hitch your hiney to a star, old closet queen. When a closet queen plays what he knows, he can't make the scene in Gucci clothes. You dress in Abercrombie boots, but you're no macho zombie toots. Hey, you're Henry Bendel at the roots. Whoa, closet queen.
Good evening, this is John Belushi, and this is the National Lampoon Radio Hour. Today, we're going to be interviewing three of the greatest superstars Hollywood's ever produced.
You're too kind.
Why don't you introduce yourselves?
Hi, John.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Oh, no. Go ahead, Chuck.
Chuck Bronson.
Clint Eastwood, John. Delighted to be here.
Clint Eastwood, Chuck Bronson.
You are so coy, dear. I'm Lee Marvin. Hi.
And Lee Marvin.
Sui.
They're here today to talk to you about something that's been on their mind for years, and they're coming out with it here for the first time. They have formed a group called the Hollywood Alliance. Did I get that wrong?
Gay Alliance.
Gay Alliance. Now, I can't believe that you gentlemen are really gay. I mean, Charles Bronson, how could you be gay?
He's an actor. He's an actor. If I may speak for Chuck, who is one of the finest actors in the business.
This is Clint Eastwood, yes.
Yes. Chuck's an actor, and he, you know, what he does and what he's been doing is a wonderful act.
Oh, you're beautiful.
But it's time to be real, isn't it, Chuck?
Excuse me, it's time to knock the closet doors, John. It's time to bust him in, if you ask me.
I'll start the ball rolling. It's the Hollywood Superstar Gay Alliance, John, and we have been thinking about this for years, and it's an organization that we've started recently, I would say in the last 9 months.
It just seems amazing to me. Here you are, Charles Bronson, Mr. Macho of the screen. How could you be gay?
In the first place, you're presuming right off the bean that because I'm gay, I can't be macho. And this is a fallacy, a myth.
It's also a myth, if I may break in, to assume that what we are on the screen is what we are off the screen, and we're not. We're actors doing an honest day's
work. I think the assumption
is
that if you're gay, you're bad. I mean, it's wrong.
And I think our biggest problem, if I may, Lee, is convincing some of our peers to come out with us.
It's amazing. What other people in Hollywood are gay? I know you hear rumors.
Who isn't, John? Let's put it that way.
No, that, who isn't? I think that's really stepping over the line. There are many heterosexuals in Los Angeles.
Name
County.
One, sweetheart.
Rod McEwen.
Well, for instance, who?
Let's just get out in the open. This girl's heels are worn down with frazzle, just number one.
Who?
I lived with Jimmy Pearsall for 2 years, and I'm saying it now.
Oh, Lee, that's a real shock. That's a real shock.
It's no shock to me, Lee.
It's no shock to me either.
There are a lot of little girls on the set coming up now who just can't step forward like we can, and we're so happy to be able to help them out.
Like who?
Just Ken Howard, for instance.
Ken Howard, right.
Ken came up to me. He was shooting that dreadful series, whatever that was called, about the two solicitors, whatever they're called. Ken came up to me crying her eyes out, said, "Where do I go? Who's going to take me?" And I just held him and said, "It'll be all right." And it was. I mean, the show flopped, didn't it? Did they pick it up?
It's that kind of compassion that Lee, for instance, has, and Clint here, and Paul Newman, who's been
Paul
doing
Newman?
A tremendous amount of work for us.
Paul Newman is gay?
Gay, of course.
I don't believe that for a minute.
Oh, well, this is...
Well, go down to headquarters and ask him. Dear, really?
He's right there. He's typing right now.
Sure.
Well, I know you've made movies with a lot of actors, like There was a movie called The Magnificent Seven. We've had Yul Brynner. And Yul Brynner, you have James Coburn.
Eli Wallach.
Now, they weren't. Yes.
Everybody in the film was gay. And I think that's how it worked, except for Horst. But
they called that the Summer of Sin when they made that movie, and we were...
Well, no, that's just...
So Horst Buchholz was the only one in that movie who wasn't gay.
That's right.
Charles Bronson, now you made a movie, The Great Escape.
May I just ask where you got that belt, John? I'm sorry to
interrupt. It's not fair. You should describe it.
I got a...
The buckle sort of looks like a snake.
I got a leather store on 10th Street somewhere.
Oh, yes.
Anyway,
The Great Escape.
The Great Escape. You made that film with a number of... James Garner, you made it with.
Steve McQueen.
Mm-hmm. Don Pleasance.
I'll never forget you and Steve McQueen on that cart when you were stuck.
You'll never forget.
Oh, God.
I think that's where I really got to know Steve well.
Steve came out just after that.
Now, you see, Steve's another small man.
He's not gay now, is he?
Well, but Steve is gay, you see.
He is.
There are some small men who are gay.
Oh, yeah?
I'm sure you'd like to know about a lot of people who are gay, and of course,
I
we're not
like
here
to
to spread the word on people who are gay, and who don't want other people to know about
it's
it.
Not a gossip.
That's
not
their
a
business.
Show.
But we are here to say that we're gay, and we are the head of a rather large organization now of gay people who are proud to be gay.
If we told you right now who people were, I mean, who, for instance, Walter Cronkite.
Walter Cronkite is gay?
Casey Stengel.
Casey Stengel, I can't
believe
Casey's
dog, you know? She has the biggest collection of tiaras I've ever seen.
Really?
For instance, there are people that you just wouldn't expect, you know, couples. I mean, people that don't know about couples, for instance. Mm-hmm. Linus Pauling and guess who? Just try to match them.
Dr. Spock.
Dr. Spock?
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, it's not important who's gay or who isn't gay. What's important to us is that...
Is how gay they are.
How gay they are.
I'm being selfish, I'm
sorry.
Yeah,
now you're making a joke of this. Is this a serious organization?
It's not only serious.
Or is it a lot of other gay groups?
He is always making jokes, always drinking. He's always a little bit out of touch.
This girl is a boozer, and she's not ashamed of it.
Oh, God, yes.
Bottle of wild turkey, and I'm happy.
Now, what about, are there any sports people that are gay?
Nitschke.
Ray.
I went out with Nitschke for 2 summers.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, who used to be known as Lou Alcindor, is gay.
Oh, boy.
Everybody knows that, of course.
That's amazing. And, I didn't know that.
When he swims, it's a sight to behold.
That beach.
Now, you can't tell me a guy like Dick Butkus is gay.
Dick Butkus is gay.
You've never seen Dick Butkus in a muumuu. He's incredibly gorgeous.
What about some rock stars?
Jerry Garcia's.
Jerry Garcia's gay? This is incredible. What about...
The Beach Boys. All of them.
They've been going steady for years.
They're going together there.
Bobby Rydell.
What about...
Dr. Stillman.
Dr. Stillman is gay?
But the whole point
certainly
is. I'm sorry.
Jay Silverheels once said to me.
Closet Queen. Acts cool and crisp. When everything inside you's crying out to let. You chose to play a shallow part. You hid your papa Gallo heart. Come on out, you old mosh, mellow tart, oh, closet queen. Closet Queen. Come out and play. Ooh, come out and play.
Hey, Asswipe, where'd you get that Sansucci amplifier?
I got it at Stereos and Stuff, Jagoff, and it only cost me $9.99.
$9.99? What a deal! For the amplifier and the tuner?
Yeah, and that's not all, shitface. I also got an anti-static record cloth and 2 HLH Crowd Quadio Quattro Quirk 3000 speakers that you're drooling all over, scumbag.
Only $9.99? I must be some sort of Neanderfuck for not having gone down to Stereos and Stuff and got one already. I gotta fire up some money. Gotta get my head up my ass sometimes.
If you've got your head up your ass about Stereos, come to Stereos and Such, located at the Bergen Shopping Mall.
And now, the White Ladies.
Gosh, Nancy, I'm so worried about Timmy.
What's the matter, Sue?
He's just so tired all the time. He gets headaches after meals, and last week he started playing with dolls.
Gee, Sue, sounds like Timmy's got gender dysphoria.
Gender dysphoria? What's that?
It's a crisis of sexual identity brought on by a complex interaction of social and biological forces.
What should I do?
Throw him out of the house. Let him live in the streets with the rest of the trash.
But he's only 8 years old.
Better late than never. Think about it, Sue. Nothing ruins breakfast like a freakish hulking she-male.
Gosh, you're right. I'll go home and throw him out this afternoon. But whatever will I tell Jim?
Tell him he's a failure, both as a father and as a man.
Thanks, Nancy. What would I do without you?
The following is a message from the American Safety Institute. Make sure that your children brush their teeth thoroughly after eating brightly colored mushrooms, odd-looking berries, and other things they may find in the woods. These foods often harbor germs that can cause tooth decay. Remember, don't be a careless person, be a care-more person.
We close our broadcasting day as usual with Nat Lamp Unto My Feet. Tonight's inspirational message will be delivered by the Reverend Otto A. Brown.
In these troubled times, when problems like political corruption, unemployment, mental illness, racial strife, and the breakup of the family seem to be ever on the increase, when one war is no sooner ended than another begins in some other part of the globe, when sometimes we get up in the morning and feel that we look out on a sea of hate which threatens to engulf everything worth saving in this tired old world of ours, in times like these, it is more important than ever that we prepare a place in our hearts where the peace and loving kindness of our Savior can enter in. Love thy neighbor, Jesus said. And we know that he meant by that not just the fellow who lives literally next door to you, but all our neighbors all around the world, whether they're black, white, or yellow, rich or poor, male or female, old or young, long hair or short hair. For how are we going to achieve the happiness and prosperity we're all striving for if we turn against one another with hate instead of love in our hearts? If we are going to preserve any hope for lasting peace in the world, we must learn to live in harmony with all races, colors, and creeds, whether Catholic, Protestant, Baptist, Communist, Atheist, Hindu, all except the Jews. Because, let's face it, the Jews killed Christ. They killed him just the same as if they had murdered him, and we can never forgive them for it. And now, thanking you for listening, this is the Reverend Otto A. Brown saying, God bless you, and good night.
You've been listening to the National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Honk, honk, why it's Wobbles.
This is London standing by. Come in, please, National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Nicht den Verstolzen, ihr Heiden, das Berlinen, das Zwingkeckerhauben, das Leinfeinkräben der National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Moskau. Did it those movies in National Lampoon Radio Hour.